We're in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Go Providence has brought a chef Antonio Dacosta from Parkside Roasteria. We're making pan-seared halibut. Good morning. Thanks for coming in on this Monday morning. Great to have you here. What are we making today?
Well, like you said, we're going to do a pan-seared halibut.
Yep.
We're going to do it Provençal style, which is from southeastern France.
Okay.
We're going to serve that with an olive tapenade, another condiment from southeastern France.
Okay, so what is going to make that, what's going to separate that from American version or and make it the southeast French version?
Provençal, known for their agriculture, great produce, so simple food. They just let their ingredients shine through. Simple roasted tomatoes, artichokes, fennel, olives, all ingredients that shine really well there.
Okay, let's go over the ingredients that we have so anybody who wants to make it can get the stuff together.
We have our halibut here. Mm-hmm. We also have some fresh lemon, a little bit of roasted fennel and pearl onion. We have pitted olives.
And what kind of olives are these? Are they the Kalamata olives?
We have Kalamatas, we have greens. It's a mixed variety you can get at any local supermarket.
Okay.
We also have some, like I said, artichokes, some fava beans, a little bit of unsalted butter. Little necks also gonna be put in that dish, roasted Roma tomatoes, a little bit of white wine. For the tapenade, a little bit different. We have some fresh cut herbs, chervil, tarragon, parsley, some more thyme and rosemary, chopped garlic, olives, your main part, some orange, and a little bit of olive oil.
All right, tell me what I'm looking for if I'm going to the market today to get my halibut.
You don't want any odor to it. You want a smell, you want a nice, firm, white fish, and it shouldn't have any odor at all. Halibut, not always so easy to find. You can always use salmon, you can always use bass, or whatever fish they have.
Okay, so this is a recipe that if we didn't have it, we could substitute something else for it.
Any fish is great, yeah.
Okay, and right here, all fresh local stuff?
Fresh local, Atlantic halibut, caught wilds, little necks, we get local, all from local purveyors, yeah.
I'm sure it makes it taste a heck of a lot better.
Makes it great.
Good stuff. All right, we have our ingredients ready to go. We're going to start putting everything together in just a little bit. Back to you.
That's right, we're back in the kitchen with Chef Antonio from Parkside Rotisserie, part of Go Providence. They brought you here today. What are we going to get started?
We're going to start with the accompaniment to our fish dish that we're going to do later, and it's going to be an olive tapenade.
Great.
Great dish, great little accompaniment, can be served with toast points, just an appetizer, or you can serve it with fish, chicken, whatever you like.
It's a big favorite here at the station. Okay, so what do we need to do?
All right, we're gonna start with a food processor, and we're gonna take off the lid, and it's kind of just dump everything in, so if you want to add all these olives in there.
What kind of olives are we using?
It's an olive mix, Greek olives, you have green olives, black olives, and Kalamata olives.
Okay.
They're brined and marinated. Some fresh herbs. Not all of it, just that's about good.
Okay.
About 2 tablespoons worth.
Gotcha.
Chervil, you can add those herbs as well. That's thyme and rosemary.
Everything or again just
you can
a
add
pinch.
All of that. Yeah, that's
right.
About 2 tablespoons worth.
Great.
We'll add 1 spoon of this minced garlic.
Heavy spoonful?
Heavy spoonful.
Okay.
I like garlic.
I like garlic too. I'm not skimping on that.
And we're now going to zest some orange zest into there.
Okay.
Careful thing when zesting an orange is you only want the outer zest. You don't want to get any of that pith. That's bitter. I only want the fruit oils from the zest on the outside.
Okay, so just stick with the... I'm doing this left-handed. This was a poor choice on my part. Sorry.
That's about good, though, right there. So we'll add our lid.
Okay.
Turn this on. Just going to slowly stream in the olive oil.
Okay. Now, why do you do it this way? Just so that way you can keep an eye on the consistency of it?
Yeah, you want to... You can adjust it to how you'd like it.
Mm-hmm.
So you can always play around with it. So we'll taste this now and see if it's where we want it, but to me it looks good.
Great.
So if you'd like to take a taste of that.
Sure. And this is kind of like the consistency that we're looking for. A little chunky.
Yeah, a little spreadable.
Oh, yum.
Salt, pepper.
I don't know.
You think it's
good? You tell me, you're the expert. I think it's delicious already.
You do it how you like. I would never add salt to it just because the olive's already salty, so I usually add a little bit of pepper.
All right, we're gonna hit it with some pepper and get the rest of this started in just a bit. Back to you.
Chef Antonio Dacosta joins us from Parkside this morning, and we are ready to cook. I'm eating olives, by the way.
There you go.
And they're good.
So I'm going to have you guys help me out.
Okay.
I'm going to start by pan-searing the halibut.
Sure.
Skin side down, so if you'd like to season it with a little bit of salt and fresh cracked pepper.
Okay. Now, when we're looking for halibut in the store, in the fish store, the market, or whatever, what should we be looking for?
Just a fresh smell. Mm-hmm. You don't want it to be too wet. You want it, you know, moist, but you don't want to see water in the bottom of the pan that it's in.
Okay.
So right here we have a nice dry piece, which is going to give us a nice sear.
You were saying it's actually hard to find sometimes, right?
It's halibut can be hard to find, especially around now. It's easier to find in the fall.
Okay.
So I put this skin side down.
Skin side down
and away from me.
You want to drop it away from you so that the oil
and not towards Will. So away from me and away from Will.
So you let that sear for a little bit.
Okay.
You know, we have a piece ready to go here through the magic of television.
All right. So How long do we sear it for?
You go about 2-3 minutes on each side. What I like to do is flip it and mm-hmm. let the flesh side cook in the oven without any vegetables in the pan.
Okay.
And that way you're going to get a nice golden brown crust on it when you pull it out.
Perfect. So that one has been in the oven.
This one's been in the oven for a little bit.
Time, temp, what should we know?
Well, it's going to be in there at 450 on convection for about 4 to 5 minutes.
Okay. All
right. Let's turn the heat on here. We'll take our tongs, we'll flip this over.
Wow, look at that color.
We got a nice golden brown crust.
That's the color.
Beautiful.
Then we can start adding our ingredients a little bit at a time. We'll start with a little bit of garlic first.
Okay. Just a little minced garlic, right?
A little bit of minced garlic, yeah.
Okay, how much you want to put in here?
That's about
and
right.
Are we putting it just in the pan itself or on the fish?
Just in the pan
just
you
the
want
pan.
It to cook up. So we're going to let this heat up a little bit more.
All right.
Okay.
Let that cook for a little while.
What other ingredients will be going into this pan?
All right. So as that garlic has to cook, we're going to start adding our fava beans.
Okay.
And we can just start adding all this veg. We have fava beans.
A little mm-hmm. Silence of the Lambs over there.
Yep.
Fava beans.
There we go.
And a nice Chianti.
Here you go. We have
Maybe
some
artichoke
hearts.
Maybe you can drink that hearts. With this dish.
Yeah.
Why not?
Why not? It would work. Some pitted olives that you've been munching on as we've been going along here.
I'm not putting all of them in because I'm saving
some.
Probably
going to snack
on them.
Michaela and I love olives.
The fennel and roasted pearl onions.
Now, was this cooked before?
That was just roasted with a little bit of salt, pepper, and olive oil.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And that's just some chopped fennel and some pearl onions.
All right.
We'll add our tomatoes that are right there.
And this is a big
just
tomato.
Roasted aromas, yeah. Go ahead, add them all in.
Yum. Okay.
We'll stir that around. There's a little bit more seasoning.
Mm-hmm. Great color in there, too.
Yeah, great healthy dish also.
Yeah.
Some lemon juice.
So if we squeeze it in.
There you go.
That was a juicy lemon.
It was. I thought the same thing.
I had it prepped for you. We squeezed it a little bit, so I was ready to go. We'll add some little necks to this dish.
Yeah.
Now, the little necks, you'll know they're done when they start to crack open.
They'll open up for you. Some white wine.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you have a pan to cover this at home, a lid, you can mm-hmm. use it. The restaurant, we kind of do this little trick. We grab a smaller saute pan, cover it right up.
And let those sit and open up.
450. It'll take about 8 minutes in the oven.
Right.
Okay.
You want the sauce to reduce a little bit. You want the clams to open up.
Mm-hmm.
When you take it out, it'll look a little bit more like this.
Yum.
Have this one ready for a little bit.
Get that finished product.
All right. So now we'll add some fresh herbs to this.
And what is this that we have?
Now we have tarragon, chervil, which is
a little...
Similar to parsley
right.
and parsley itself.
Okay.
We'll add a little bit of butter.
As you're doing that, remind everyone where you guys are located.
76 South Main Street in Providence, Rhode Island.
Mm-hmm.
Open lunch Monday through Friday, dinner 7 days a week.
And you have specials because of Lent too, right?
Yep, every Friday for lunch we're doing fish and chips, oyster po' boys, little neck sandwiches, mm-hmm. And for dinner we'll have a very nice seafood special for you, maybe more than one, two, or three, a scallop appetizer.
Nice.
It differs every day, so.
Good.
Something
good
for everyone, and if you want this recipe so you can make it at home, head on over to our website, WPRI.com.